Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about the incredible solar probe mission, which is currently exploring the outermost part of the sun's atmosphere. Launched in August 2018, the solar probe is a spacecraft designed to fly directly into the sun's corona, the super hot region of plasma that surrounds the star. It's the closest any spacecraft has ever come to the sun. And it's already providing us with some incredible insights into this mysterious region of our solar system. One of the key goals of the solar probe is to help us better understand the sun's magnetic field. Scientists believe that this field is responsible for driving many of the sun's most dynamic and dangerous phenomena, including solar flares and coronal mass ejection. By studying the magnetic field up close, the solar probe is helping us to build a more complete picture of the processes that power our sun. Another important aspect of the solar probe mission is its focus on solar wind. This is the constant stream of particles that the sun is constantly spewing out into space. By measuring the properties of the solar wind close to the sun, the solar probe is helping us to better understand how it interacts with the Earth's magnetic field and atmosphere, and how it can cause space weather events that can affect satellites, power grids, and other technology. Overall, the solar probe is an incredible mission that's pushing the boundaries of what we thought was possible. It's providing us with a unique window into the inner workings of our sun and helping us to better understand how it shapes the space environment around us. I can't wait to see what new discoveries this mission will bring in the years to come. Where is solar probe now? As of my knowledge, cut off in September 2020, when the solar probe mission was still ongoing and the spacecraft was in its seventh orbit around the sun. At that time, it was about 21 million miles, 34 million kilometers, from the sun's surface, traveling at a speed of about 330,000 miles per hour, 532,000 kilometers per hour. However, the solar probe's orbit is constantly changing as it gets closer to and farther away from the sun, so its current location may be different now. You can check NASA's solar probe website or mission social media accounts for the latest updates on the spacecraft's location and discoveries. Why solar probe is not melting? The solar probe spacecraft was designed to withstand the extremely high temperatures and radiation levels near the sun. It has a special heat shield made of a carbon composite material about 4.5 inches, 11.43 centimeters, thick that protects the spacecraft and its instruments from the intense heat of the sun. The heat shield is designed to withstand temperatures of up to 2,500 degrees Fahrenheit, 1,377 degrees Celsius, which is hotter than the melting point of most metals. It also has a special cooling system that uses water to absorb and dissipate some of the heat. In addition to the heat shield, the solar probe has other design features that help it withstand the harsh conditions near the sun. For example, it has a special power system that can handle the extreme temperature variations, and its instruments are carefully insulated and shielded to protect them from the intense radiation. Overall, the solar probe is a marvel of engineering and design, and it's a testament to the ingenuity and expertise of the scientists and engineers who created it. Can solar probe return to the Earth after completing the mission? No, the solar probe spacecraft is not designed to return to Earth after completing its mission. The spacecraft is on a trajectory that takes it into increasingly closer orbits around the sun, and it does not have the propulsion system or fuel reserves necessary to escape the sun's gravity and return to Earth. Instead, once the solar probe has completed its mission, it will continue to orbit the sun until its systems eventually fail or it is no longer able to communicate with Earth. This is a common fate for many spacecraft that are sent on missions to explore other planets or the depths of space. However, the data and scientific discoveries gathered by the solar probe will continue to be analyzed and studied by scientists for years to come, helping to advance our understanding of the sun and its effects on the solar system. The spacecraft uses a high-gain antenna to transmit data back to Earth at a rate of up to 430,000 bits per second, which is much faster than most home internet connections. However, because the solar probe is so far away from Earth, it can take up to several hours for the data to reach scientists on the ground. The data collected by the solar probe includes information about the sun's magnetic field, plasma waves, and high-energy particles, as well as images and other measurements of the sun's atmosphere and surface. This data is being used by scientists around the world to better understand the sun and its effects on the solar system. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more space news and updates.